hard.
Must be great to be an athlete. You retire and you get this whole thing. Yeah. The rest of us, we get a stupid gold watch and a box for our crap.
Watch the guy that's coming in throw your stuff out, all your ideas out the dumpster.
Not even a watch. Maybe like dinner with your fellow employees, and half of them can't even show up because they have better things to do than go to your retirement party.
Go home and see your wife with a vacuum cleaner on and her shoes
askew,
and she's just dead.
There's a great line in that movie about Nicholson. He goes, "Yeah, I hate my wife's smell. My wife's smell bothers me, just like her skin or her whatever." It's so funny.
Bout Schmidt is one of the funniest movies. If you look at if you watch it differently. God, I told the story. When I saw that movie, I was laughing so hard in the theater. Old ladies were getting really, really mad.
Of course.
So pissed off. But it was so ridiculous, you had to laugh. Everything went wrong for the poor guy.
The best, though, was when he retired, and the new guy was coming in, and he's trying to give him some advice about the job, and the new guy doesn't want to hear it, and then he goes
and
out.
All these files that he's been saving for 30 years.
30 years of his life's work in this place. And, you know, he actually told the guy, you know, I got a lot of stuff here that maybe you can use.
It'll make your job easier, the transition easier, all my files, all the research I did in this place.
All of his work. And then as he's leaving, he's passing the dumpster out back, and all those files are in the dumpster.
His life's work at
the
job.
They just threw it away. You are nothing.
Wasn't it awkward that he's sitting there talking to the guy about you could do this, and the guy's like, okay, yeah, no, cool. Yeah, the guy's being polite to him, which made it even worse. Like,
yeah, made it more like that's how somebody would really deal with the situation, you know. Yeah, yeah, be all cool, but then when he leaves, it's like, all right.
And then it's one thing after another, then he goes home, and his wife, is dead with the shoe off.
The vacuum cleaner's going.
And then
she was just vacuuming the house and keeled over.
See, I started watching that movie, and I was in shock in the beginning. But by the time he's in the RV, and now what, he's driving cross country to see his daughter, who doesn't give a crap about him anymore. And then when he stops in front of where his childhood home was. And before they even showed the childhood home, in quotes here, I started laughing because I knew that had to be some horrific thing, too. And it's a tire store. And the guy's like, yeah, I guess you could come in. And he's kind of like reminiscing and like trying to figure out where his bedroom used to be in this tire store. And the guy's in the background selling radials to somebody. Oh, I howled. It was so funny.
The house had been gone for years. They'd knocked it down and built a tire store. His childhood home. That film is funny.
All right, here's more Michael.